Good morning, saints of God. How are you doing today? Well, we're in Romans chapter number 8 still, and we're looking at verse 26 and 27 and 28. We're talking about the Spirit here and how the Spirit helps us to pray. We really don't know how to pray like we should, and we begin to realize that the Holy Spirit takes all this groanings and all this ache of the heart and all of our real feelings, and the Holy Spirit takes them and offers them up to the Lord. So he makes intercession for us there. Look what it says here in verse 26. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray. In other words, we don't really know how we ought to pray, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Wonderful, powerful passage right there when you think about it, how that the Holy Spirit doesn't just save us, doesn't just seal us, doesn't just lead us and guide us and direct us, but there the precious Holy Spirit comes and he makes intercession. He prays on your behalf and on my behalf. And isn't it a wonderful truth to know that we have the sweet Holy Spirit living inside of us? But I want you to listen to this verse, verse 28. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. Now, you know, I know you've heard it said 100 times before. It doesn't say that all things are good, but it does say that all things work together for good. And you know, this whole time through the book of Romans, we've been talking about what man's been dealing with, about his estate. First of all, how could he get right with God? Well, he in of himself can't get right with God. It took Jesus Christ to make us right with God. Now after that, we got to learn this Christian life and living in the Spirit. And one truth that the Apostle Paul really parks on right here in Romans chapter number 8, verse 28, is that we need to realize that God is doing all these things in our life. And even though we don't like them, it's terrible, but he's working these things out according to his purpose. We need to always remember that God loves us and that God intends the best for us. And the best for us would be, and we'll read this tomorrow, being conformed to the image of Jesus Christ. You know, we want to have the mind of Christ. We want to be like Christ. And that's the best life. And so he's working on us until that point. But we see here that all these things work together for good. You know, we battle, we struggle against all kinds of, you know, discouragement and trials and corruptions of life. We have the bombardments of our own conscience. We have the relentless accusations made outside and by others. And even our own spirit sometimes has accusations against us. Our body, the pain and the decay that we see that goes on here. We have to live with fear and hopelessness at times. You know, we have aging bodies. We have to think about death and hurt and sorrow, loneliness. All these kind of things creep into our thinking. And then the world's cruelty, and not only that, the condemnation that the world is already in, brings a lot of stuff into our life. But we got to realize this truth, that God loves us. And even though these things come into our life, God is working them out for good for us. I used to work at Weyerhaeuser. And at Weyerhaeuser, I worked on a 24-24 ward. It was a gigantic machine, about half the size of our auditorium at the church, just a gigantic piece of equipment. And me and it took two people to operate this machine. I operated the end that would be called the stacking end, and somebody else would operate the loading end of it. And what was so interesting is we take a board, now a corrugated piece of cardboard, we called it a board, and they would put it into a hopper, and that hopper would feed these boards through a machine about one board about every 2.5 seconds or so, something like that. And it would go through this machine and these blades would cut it and turn it and twist it and fold it and bend it and do all kinds of things to it, spin it around another die. And then after that, it would go through this other die that had some ink on it and would print the pictures on it. And as it went through this machine, it was beat up like you wouldn't believe. But when it came out on the other side, it was made into a beautiful box. And for 4 years, I made tomato boxes, dime-ear tomato boxes, and they would come out just beautiful. But it had to go through all this tribulation to come out beautiful. You know, really, life is like that. We are born and we have to go through what we call life. And sometimes life can be very rough. Sometimes life can send us through things. But God's got a plan through all of it. When we get through with it all, we're going to come out conformed to the image of Jesus Christ, meant for the Master, His use. And it's got a glorious truth we need to know about. And that's what He's teaching us here today. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we love You and thank You for all that You're doing for us. Father, we pray today for these that are in the hospital. We pray for Bill Cantor. We pray for Bill Gurney. And Lord, talking just yesterday to Bill Howard, things sound so good for him, Lord. We pray You continue to bless him. Lord, for Benjamin, we pray that You would bless him and be with him. Give him Your strength and peace of mind, Father. And Lord, we just pray that we would realize, though these things come into our life, Father, help our faith to be increased. Help us to trust You, Father, as we realize the great truth that You are working to conform us into that precious image of Jesus Christ. Father, what a great day when we come out on the other side, fit for Your use. Lord, we love You and thank You in Christ's name. Amen. Go serve your King. God bless you. Have a Jesus-filled day. Amen. Bye.